Indonesian Marines are pouring into the area devastated by an earthquake and tsunami to help with rescues. The death toll climbed overnight to more than 1,420. Indonesia still has not evacuated all of the injured 6 days after the disasters. Ben Tracy is in hard-hit Palu with the growing sense of despair.
Nearly 70,000 people here are now homeless. There's no drinking water, there's no electricity, there's nowhere to buy food. And for 6 days now, people have been waiting for help to arrive.
The Indonesian military is finally here with an army of supplies. Boxes of water, instant noodles, and giant sacks full of clothes. All of it is desperately needed at the many makeshift homeless camps that have sprung up all over the disaster zone. This woman named Endong has been here with her one-year-old daughter Wuhan for 6 days. A tent is their only protection from 90-degree heat. They have had to drink water from the nearby river, which is also being used as a toilet.
Do you have any idea of how long you'll be here?
She says, I don't know where to go. I no longer have a home. Her home was wiped out by the tsunami triggered by the 7.5 magnitude earthquake last Friday. The scars on Wuhan's face are from being rolled by the tsunami waves. She says, it is a miracle we found her alive. I thank God she has a new life. While we were at the homeless camp, we also saw this man walking around, wearing a sign.
It basically says, I'm looking for my wife and I'm looking for my son. And he just told me that he has not seen either of them since the earthquake happened 6 days ago.
He's holding out hope that they may still be alive. But this is what his neighborhood now looks like. Every single home reduced to piles of charred debris.
And we're told that more than 700 homes were destroyed here during the earthquake. There is now so much debris here and so little to move it with that it's hard to imagine how long it's going to take for them to try to find all the people who are likely buried here. Sadly, they expect to find many more victims. This city holds a mass burial every day and just dug its second mass grave. For CBS This Morning, Ben Tracy, Palu, Indonesia.
Ben Tracy, thanks. That cardboard sign just breaks your heart.
Well, mass graves, too. I mean,
the numbers are staggering, too. Yeah. I hear the numbers.